choose the most. Okay, because it's easy. You guys know what you've experienced in life and how to make connections. So let's go to TT. What is a TT? Let's read it together.
That reminds me of something else I've read or watched. Another book, a movie, TV program, or video.
All right, who has made a text-to-text connection in this story? You can compare sounder to another book, a movie, or TV program.
Yeah, pull it together, baby, okay?
Yeah. Where the Red Fern Grows, how are they similar?
Both of the dogs get hurt.
He's comparing this book to another book. We'll do one more.
Sounder
to
Shiloh.
That's what I was thinking. How are they the same?
Because the dogs get hurt.
Okay, I know this isn't easy, but we'll go. You'll get a chance to do this. Text to world. Let's read this one together. Ready?
The text reminds me of something from current events, something going on in the world, a famous person or event. The text makes me think about a bigger issue, theme, usually not stated in the text.
So anytime we've talked about our three themes, we would put text to world because this is what's one of our themes? Make the best of what you have, always try your hardest. That's a theme we see in a lot of different things. Stories, books, the world. Okay, can anyone make a text-to-world connection? Knowing that theme is text-to-world. Give me a time where any of our theme things came up. I'm gonna go and explain it a little more because I see some confusing faces. So one of our themes was be courageous, never give up. That's a theme in life, right? Does that affect a lot of us? We have to be courageous in life and never give up? That's why we consider this a text-to-world connection. Being courageous is something that affects everybody in the world. So who can make a text-to-world connection?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, we had a family theme of being responsible and loyal to our family.
And Sandra, the boy, had to watch his family. So
the mother.
Yeah, he had a lot of family responsibilities. That's a world. That's a theme that affects a lot of us in the world. Yep, babysitting, taking care of your family. How about Christopher?
About being courageous and never giving up. My dad told me a story about a guy, and I think it was either the military or the Marines, and he won the Medal of Honor and got up on a burning tank and started fending off his troop
awesome.
For over
so,
an hour.
So that the book you could compare to the story you heard from your dad, a text to world connection about the theme of being courageous and never giving up. We're going to keep going so we can get through this. When would you write a question mark? Fifth graders in the back, when would you write a question mark? Sam?
When you have a question about the test?
Yeah, text. When you're confused, when you have a question, here would be one time I would write your question out. I would use words. I don't understand why the boy knew his father wasn't there. That part was confusing, right?
Yeah.
He's like, I know my dad's not here now, but it never really explained how he knew. We had to infer that. How about a P? We talked about this kind of on the last page. Everybody?
Prediction.
Prediction. If you think you know what's coming up next, write a P. B. What's B?
Visualizing.
Can anybody explain visualizing to me in fifth grade terms? Carter?
The writer is helping me make pictures in my head. Good sensory details help me see, hear, taste, smell, and touch.
Okay.
It is almost like I'm watching a movie.
Right. Carter, can you pick a scene from this story, because this book doesn't have pictures, where the scene was really clear in your mind?
When he
saw the schoolhouse. Right. The author went into a ton of detail. What the kids were doing, what the schoolhouse looked like, how the kids were acting, the noises, the... I have gone into smell, like the smells, sound, what he saw, what he heard. Okay, that's a good visualization. We're going to go on. We have two more. A TF. This one normally just pertains to nonfiction. What's TF, everybody?
Text feature.
Those are maps, fen, charts, subtitles, captions, titles, bold, italicized types. We rarely see these in fiction. Okay, so I haven't come across any of these in Sounder. Have you guys come across? Not really.
There's pictures.
We've had italics. What were you saying, Christopher?
The subtitle is kind of like a chapter number.
Yep, chapter numbers would be a subtitle. And the last one, main idea. This is pretty straightforward. What do you think, or when you come across what you think is the main idea, either of a chapter or a certain section in a book? We have 5 minutes. Do you have a question?
No.
Yeah. So what I tended to do when I taught with my students is I would say, all right, after we read chapter 8, you need to go back and put an MI where you think the main idea happened in chapter 8. We always did main idea at the end. It's hard to figure out the main idea when you're in the middle of reading a chapter because you don't know until you finish a chapter. Okay, so I have ran the first 3 pages of chapter 8. Okay, first 3 pages, right? And I'm going to require a certain amount of annotation codes. Are we able to keep it together for 5 more minutes, Brady? Okay. Who are we missing here today?
Okay.
Hannah. Who are we missing by Brady?
No one.
No one sits by Brady?
No.
Go ahead and write your name on this so we don't lose it. Yeah, you can fold it if you want.